This episode of Amplified is brought to you by Lynda.com. Get 7 days free at Lynda.com/Amplified. And go to SoundmanCA.com today to get your Amplified t-shirts and your Soundman iPad dash kits. Where's the weed at? Today we're going to talk about the speaker installation in the 2015 Toyota Tundra. The first thing I did is get the factory speaker out of the door. We need to make some adapters that bolt into the factory speaker location and house our new speaker replacement. Goddamn Japanese bastards! Why can't the plug just flop apart like a Chevy? We're gonna be using these Audison Voce mids, and damn, they look nice. Can't be fucking around here, because these are nice. If the speakers are ugly, you can just hang them in the hole with one drywall screw. But if they're nice, you need to make the proper adapter. So that's what we're gonna do. This adapter is going to take the place of the factory speaker and have a perfect cutout to house our new Audison mid. This will be nice when this is all done. I'll be able to jump in and out of the vehicle with my shoes. Because normally I put my shoes next to the car and I step out like this. You know what I'm saying? You don't want to get your socks dirty either. So then we're looking like this. You can't work good like this. I'm going to use a circle jig to cut a perfect hole that's going to fit this mid.
It went wrong somewhere.
Now I'm going to copy the shape of this factory speaker with my flush trim bit sent to me by 12 Volt Tools. The factory speaker is going to ride along the bearing, and the cutting area of the bit is going to cut the wood. Bada bing, you got yourself an adapter. Now we're gonna copy the tweeter bracket as well, so we can replace that factory tweeter with the Audison tweeter. get it nice and straight. Nice and straight like your dad isn't. Okay, and then... I made a second trim plate to space the mid out just a little bit more because the magnet was touching the window track, and we can't have that happen. So we're just gonna give a little bit of So we can cover the harness, that way I can't run any wires. Now we're gonna replace this plastic flappy shit with some sound deadener material. In these doors, we're not gonna go ape shit with the sound deadener material. Some of you guys cover every damn thing in the door with your sound deadener. You're overusing this shit. You're sticking it everywhere. For some reason, you guys think this is some kind of competition to see who could pack the most layers of sound deadening material in your door panel. I saw a dude stuffing Pink Panther house insulation up in his doors. The idea is just to close these big holes up and stiffen the door panel so that when the mid's bumping, we don't have any plastic flapping. We don't need the shit so thick that it's thicker than my fucking house roof. I saw a dude tar roofing tiles into his door panel before. He said it sounded good. I'm gonna use some of this chipboard to stiffen up this hole so the DynaMat's not just kinda hanging. The reason closing these holes makes the mid sound better is because it's creating a baffle which separates the front wave of the speaker from the back wave. You can't have your back wave jumping around up and getting all in the way of your front wave. It's gonna fuck up your wave. I once saw a guy put so much sound deadener in his interior, he couldn't get his interior panels back onto the car. So he was driving around with silver ass sound deadener, looked like tinfoil wrapped around his steering wheel, looked like the inside of the International Space Station. Wires and tinfoil. He had to wear 3 pairs of sunglasses because of the glare. People were pulling over, they thought it was a cop coming. But that was his Pioneer radio flashing with the tinfoil interior. People pulling off the road. Okay, now I could just be like this. Before it was bad to do this. But now it's good. So I'm just gonna stop that in place. That's all we're doing for today. Close her up. Now we stiffened up the inner skin. We didn't oversound deaden the shit out of the door and cover all the goddamn bolts, which is good. If a Toyota mechanic needs to work on the inner skin of the door to replace a window motor or something of that nature, he needs to be able to get to the bolt. Because if sound deadener material's covering the bolt hole, he's not gonna know what to do. And the world's gonna end. He's gonna be looking in his manual and trying to put the fucking ratchet on the bolt. We're not working with fucking geniuses here. You gotta make it easy on people. You gotta be easy on people. As you can see here, these mids are bolted in tightly. This is what we call proper installation integrity. That's some long words. You can pause the shit and look them up one by one. I don't give a fuck. What I'm trying to show you here is that these mids are in and they're not going anywhere. And that's how you do it. Go to soundmanca.com and pick yourself up an Amplified t-shirt and help support the show. And while you're there, check out the genuine Soundman iPad dash kits. And once you get your iPad kit, make sure you contact Rafa, have him install the iPad in your dash. You can mail it to him, he'll send it back to you. You don't even have to get out of your damn chair. Also check out our sponsor for today, lynda.com. Lynda.com is the number one learning resource on the internet. They have comprehensive video tutorials in a wide variety of subjects. Right now, they're giving Amplified fans a free trial so you can check it out for yourself and see if you like it. You don't even have to buy nothing. Browser-wide selection of video tutorials, you can learn how to make videos like me and put yourself on YouTube. Lynda.com/Amplified. See what you could learn in 7 days. I also want to thank 12 Volt Tools for sending me these awesome router bits. They got a bunch of awesome new router bits. Go check them out. There's a link in the description. We'll see you guys next time.